Hello friends, welcome to Learn Electronics India. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to scroll the display. Here you can see, this is a scrolling text, and as this text ends, we have another static message. Hello friends. So let's learn how to do this. First, here we are printing 1 letter. Once it gets completed to 16 letters, then we are scrolling. This is the circuit where pin number first of LCD, that is ground, is connected to the ground, power is connected to plus 5 volt supply, and contrast pin is connected to the potentiometer. Middle pin of the potentiometer is connected to the contrast pin. Similarly, resistor select pin is connected to pin number 12 of Arduino. And similarly, enable pin is connected to pin number 11 of Arduino, and read write operation is connected to ground because we are going to write something on LCD. Again, since we are working in a 4-bit mode, so data bit 4, 5, 6 and 7, these 4 bits are connected to pin number 5, 4, 3 and 2 respectively with the Arduino, and anode of the LED. Means of LCD is connected to power supply with the help of resistor, and cathode is connected to ground. This is the overall circuit arrangement, and now let's understand that what's happening, what is the algorithm. There are many ways to scroll the LCD, so there are some important functions which are used to scroll the LCD. There are some built-in functions which we can directly use to scroll the LCD. For example, we have taken an LCD variable of type liquid crystal, and we are configuring the LED in 4-bit mode, that is resistor select, enable pin and these 4 bits data. So there are some functions like the LCD auto scroll. This will scroll automatically the LCD, and no auto scroll will stop the scrolling. Now there are some functions which are used to text. For example, if we are writing scroll display left, it means that virtually we are dragging the display towards left. It means that the letters will seem to be moving towards right. Similarly, when we are calling scroll display right, it means that we are virtually moving the LCD towards right. It means that the words or letters will seem to be moving towards left. Similarly, when we have to move the text direction, so there are two functions used for it. First one is right to left, and second one is left to right. In this case, the text will move towards left from the right, means leftward movement will be there. Now coming to our own logic, because we are going to use our own logic, not the built-in functions. Suppose, for example, we are taking the text of type string, welcome to Learn Electronics India. So we are going to use few functions. For example, text.charAt. For example, if I am writing the index number 3, then 0, 1, 2, 3. It means C will be selected and we will get the output as C. Similarly, text.length, we are not going to count that because maybe we can change the string too. So we are calling text.length. This will return us the length of the string text. Now the next function is text.substring. We can specify that from which character or which index to up to which index we are going to select the text. For example, if I'm writing substring 3,7, it means that we are taking the third index but less than 7 index, means 3 to 6. So here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 means come will be output, not blank white space. This will not come, only come will be given as an output. Now it's not like any magic that we are going to scroll the LCD. It's the only thing is that first time we are printing this 16 letters, and next time we are selecting the string substring starting from E to next 16 letters. Similarly from next, and we print from the starting, means cursor point will be 0,0 only. This is how you will feel that LCD is scrolling or text is scrolling. Now coming to the code part, there is one header file liquidcrystal.h is included, and we are going to configure the LCD. And LCD.setCursor 1,1, first we are going to write the static part, that is hello friends, which you sign the output. So we are going to set the cursor at first column and first row, means 0 and second row. Again in the scrolling part, what we are going to do, we have selected a text which is welcome to learn electronics India. We are taking two integers i, j. J is started from 0. Now as I have already told that we are first going to write text by text, means one letter and another letter up to 15, then we will start scrolling the text. So since index LCD index starts from 0 and ends up to 15, so we are taking first 15 and then set cursor at i,0, means for the first text when I equal to 0, 0,0 position will be selected, and for the second 1,0 will be selected, and similarly others will be selected. And we are going to select the text char at ith position, means when I is equal to 0 then w will be selected, when I equal to 1 e will be selected, when I equal to 2 then l will be selected, similarly for the others. We are giving a proper delay so that we can visualize this, that yes, this is happening. If I is greater than 15, then there are two processes. First we are going to take substring, as I have already discussed earlier. We are going to select a few part, one part of the string. Suppose first j equal to 0, now j plus plus, means j equal to 1. So we are going to select the string from e to next 16 letters, like 16th letter will not be selected, so 1j and other 15, we will get all the 16 letters and we will print again. So we are setting cursor at 0,0 at each time, and lcd.print text dot substring j,j16. This process will occur for all the from I equal to 16 to the remaining length. This much time this will scroll again, and we are giving a proper delay. And now coming to the setup part, in the setup part we are starting the LCD 16x2, and in the loop part we are calling first a static loop and giving a proper delay 1000 milliseconds, means 1 second. Again lcd.clear, and now scrolling loop. So scrolling loop will make the LCD to do so. This text, that is welcome to learn electronics India, it will be moving towards the left direction because we are taking the substring in that way. Now we will check that whether there are no errors. Let's verify it. As you can see here that there are no errors present. Now we can upload the program and check the output.